have no limits! Whoever my opponent, their might is nothing compared to mine! I will crush them!
Yo! Boom! Boom! What up? What is going on, everybody? Detective Jerz is here for 2K20. Now, this is going to be an open discussion video. Feel free to drop your comments down below. You know what I'm saying? A lot of this stuff is not 100% confirmed, so chill out. Do not come after me, you feel me? Because I drop kick your moms. Like, chill out. This is going to be an open discussion video. We're going to be talking about 2K20. We're going to be talking about LD today. We're going to be talking about Agent Zero, a.k.a. Beamstar. We're going to be talking about body physique. We're going to be talking about a lot of the covers of the 2K theories that are going around, park affiliations. So without further ado, man, let's get this video popping. I want to say thank you guys so much for hitting that goal yesterday. I really wanted 13.3 and you guys got it. Yo, can y'all smash this? Let's get this to 13.225. Right now we at 13.319. Make sure y'all smash. Let's get it lit. Let's get it popping. Hold on. Before we get into the video, this is a picture of the Wade cutout that is going in GameStop. Why is this man looking into Wade's eyes? Wade looked like he's about to slam on him and take his soul. I'm not gonna lie, I saw the actual 3D cutout today at GameStop, man. I wanted to take it and just run, bro. I wanted to take it and just bounce. It looks amazing. Now we're gonna get into the news. We're gonna be talking about LD. Yo, LD is so heavily, like, influenced, and like, yo, he just loves the 2K community, and I love the fact that YouTubers can reach him or anybody and he responds back. It is definitely amazing. Now, first picture we got, right, it's coming from what is his name, Mario, I believe. He's telling LD, miss these days when I can have my own clothes in the JRC. Now, if you're really not familiar with the community of 2K, back in the day, you were able to wear whatever clothes you wanted, didn't even matter, and go play. And you know what I'm saying? The teams would just be divided. But what LD says is that people complain about wait times and it being confused and not being able to separate your teammates apart. And unfortunately, just off that feedback, it is letting me know that we will never get that ever again. 2K20 will not have this. I'm pretty sure that it's not gonna have it just off his feedback. Second, we got somebody that was coming at LD's neck, bro. He was coming at LD. He said, tell me, LD, why should I buy 2K20? It's just gonna be some more BS as 2K19. It's gonna be the same damn game, just a different neighborhood. Same people running two centers on the two or two locks. And LD hit him with the, you feel me, that face. He hit him with that, mine's probably horrible, but he hit him with that face. And that right there, man, we have to eliminate this on 2K20. You should not be able to run two centers on the game, bro. You should not be able to run two centers on twos. I don't know if 2K is gonna find a way to eliminate that where, you know what I'm saying, it's a guard, and then you know what I'm saying, I don't know. I don't know how they're gonna eliminate that, but we're gonna see. And he's talking about the neighborhood. And LD, man, LD's a man of his word. If you follow him, he's never like amped things up and then we were like, oh, you know what I'm saying? So like, I do believe that the neighborhood is gonna be more than one neighborhood and you're not gonna be able to run two centers on the twos. Let me know down below how you guys feel about this. Now we're gonna be talking about Agent, aka Beam Starts video. Now he put out a video that caught my eyes. Yo, Agent, if you're watching this video, do not copyright me, bro. Do not copyright. I'm subscribed to your channel. I got the notifications and everything, but I know he's a man of the community, so I ain't really gotta worry. Now he put out a video and there was two things that really caught my interest. One, the fact about smaller players in terms of speed, and second, body features, body physique. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You big people with no neck, or you got the little scrawny people that got the lowest weight. That should really matter in 2K20. Now, this is a picture that I got on Google for 2K20, and bro, that looks amazing. I don't know what that is, the whole framework. If you know what this little symbol is meaning, like, you know what I'm saying, like, that's like the flash symbol. Can you let me know down below, what is this symbol from? I have no idea. I haven't even looked it up. I probably should have, but let me know down below, what does this symbol mean? If you know what it means, comment down below. Now, in terms of the smaller players, what I have a problem with is that the fact that smaller player guards are running, you know what I'm saying? And then you have bigger players, you know what I'm saying? Like stretches, for example, or post scores or glass cleaners. Why are they running the same speed as a guard? That's not even basketball. You trying to tell me that Shaq could guard Kyrie? He could guard AI in a coast-to-coast? No, hell no. Yo, Shaq would have to. As soon as his team scores the ball, he's already running back because he got to get on defense. There is no way that should be happening in 2K20, bro. They have to get it. They're trying to make a realistic basketball game. That's what Ronnie keeps on trying to pick at. Well, you got to fix that, bro. There's no way that this big ass player is running the same speed as me.
NBA 2K, show some love to the smaller, quicker players. Slam dunk champ out.
Just like that.
I don't think I've ever heard more fact. They don't show any love to guards. And like I said, centers and guards move at the same speed. Yes. Ronnie, are you listening?
I'm shorter, I'm faster. It makes no sense whatsoever. Then secondly, body physique. I think it would be amazing. In terms of the weight, I don't know how they would do this. I know somebody said that you should be able to go to the gym and tone your player out and then make him faster. But honestly, I feel like that will create some demigods and it would just break the game. You know what I'm saying? I just got to call out. See, I think that will break the game. 2K, do not do that. 2K, do not do that. Somehow, some way, people will find a ways to get around it, create some demigod that is now able to speed boost or whatever the case is. Do not do that, 2K. But I do think that bodies and stuff should matter. You know what I'm saying? If you're a guard, you're a small forward, power forward, we all shouldn't have the same bodies. You know, because not everybody in the NBA is just, like, for example, LeBron James, big as hell, stocky, versus Kyle Lowry, which is short, kind of fat, little medium. I don't know what you want to call his body type, but you know what I'm saying? There's a difference. So I think 2K20 should really analyze that because they do an amazing job with the face scan, which I don't understand why they can't get the bodies just right.
Ronnie, 2K, get different physique styles up in there, man. Facts. I'm gonna have to wrap these biceps around your neck, boy.
All right, the way we're gonna wrap this up, look, I'm still sticking to my theory. I do think there's gonna be three neighborhoods: Flyers, Ballers, and Rough Riders, you know, River, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm talking about. I do think there's gonna be three different ones just based off the covers. I really do think there's gonna be three different neighborhoods, but I just don't know how they're gonna do it though. You know what I'm saying? I hope they don't do something like this. Now picture this though. What if they give us like a 2K19 kind of park layout, but this court over here would be Flyers, that court over there would be Rivet, that court over there would be Sunset, but it's all still the same. I hope they don't do that. I kind of want it to be three different neighborhoods, three different places. But I do think that Pro-Am, the sneaker store, anything outside of the park should be separate, because a lot of people load it to the same server, then they run to Pro-Am, they run to the Foot Locker, they go get a haircut, and when they return, you don't get put back into that same park that you was in. So now we just lost like 20 players that were supposed to be in the park, and now nobody's playing us because a lot of people are already running. They need to take out Elite out the game. Take it out. They need to take that out of the game, or show it when you're actually in the game already. Like, it's too late already. Oh, like, we playing Elite. It's too late. Grab the remote, learn how to play, and start getting busy. Like, do not have that, because people are gonna run. You can't make one mistake and then do it again. It makes no sense. It makes no sense to learn from a mistake and then do it again in a whole nother game. No sense whatsoever. I haven't done one of these in a while. We're gonna be doing a Jerz challenge. Now, I got two challenges because I don't know which one y'all really want to do, whatever the case is, but it's pretty cool. I do read the comments and I do reply to everybody. Starting from 2K, let's go 2K15. Starting from 2K15 to currently 2K19, start from the best 2K to the worst 2K. You know what I'm saying? I want to hear your guys' opinions. Comment it down below. And secondly, if you don't want to do that, I have something on the screen. What would be the best duel out of these duels? For A, we got the Greek Freak, we got Klay Thompson, right? For B, we got Booker, we got LeBron James. You know what I'm saying? Hey, man, you got the GOAT, you got LeBron. C, we have Blake Griffin, Kyrie Irving. And then for D, this is a mean one, I'm not gonna lie. They have KD and they got Paul George. If I had to choose out of all those, man, I don't know, because these kind of hard, man. Two big ass players. I'm going with my boy LeBron, bro. I'm going with my boy LeBron, but my favorite player is on there, Kyrie. But he got Blake Griffin. You know what I'm saying? If Blake Griffin and Kyrie were supposed to play, if they played Booker and LeBron, yo, LeBron's gonna, you know what I'm saying? LeBron's gonna carry. But it is what it is. I don't think Blake could guard LeBron, you know what I'm saying? But Kyrie might give, you know what I'm saying? He might give Booker the work, though. I'm not gonna lie to you. But let me know down below. Yo, please smash that like button. Hit them noties, bro. I need y'all to hit these noties so y'all can get every single notie when I drop a video. Because we dropping bangers every single day, bro. We dropping bangers every single day. But it's your boy Jerz, man. Stay blessed. Who knows what we're gonna do next? And I'm out, yeah.